Welcome to all to this episode of Peecs. Today in this episode, we are mainly discussing the chemical properties of alkyl halides. Before going to the detailed explanation, you must know some basic points regarding the stereochemistry, especially the optical activity and optical isomerism. See, you know, you have learned last year, the whole isomerism shown by organic compounds can be classified into two types, as structural isomerism and stereoisomerism. Structural isomerism arises due to the difference in their structure if they are having the same molecular formula, but the stereoisomerism arises due to the different spatial arrangement of atoms. There are two types of stereoisomerism shown by organic compounds. They are geometrical as well as optical isomerism. Before going to the optical activity, you must know the term plane polarized lights. See, ordinary light wave is a transverse wave. When a light wave passed through, it vibrates in all directions perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the wave. When such a light wave is passed through, a crystal such as nickel, tourmaline or quartz, the emergent beam consists of vibrations only in one direction. Means, suppose this is the wave, this kind of vibrations only allowed, all other vibrations are restricted. Now, here the vibrations shown like this, only in one direction, and now this light is known as plane polarized lights. See, this is the ordinary beam of light passed through crystal, the emergent beam, there are vibrations only in one plane, now it is known as plane polarized lights. When this plane polarized light is passed through these organic solutions, now the plane of vibration of this plane polarized lights is rotating towards right or towards left by this compound. So, now if it is rotating towards right, the compound is known as dextro. This compound is known as dextro, represented by small d or positive sign. If the rotation of the plane polarized light is towards left, it is leo, represented by small l or negative sign. So, the ability of this compound, ability of a compound to rotate the plane of vibration of the plane polarized light either towards right or towards left is known as optical activity. See, what are the conditions for a compound is to be optically active? Is it water an optically active compound, or methanol, ethanol, all these are optically active? The answer is no, because there must be certain conditions for a compound is to be optically active. These are the conditions. One of the condition is chirality. The molecule should be chiral, and the second condition is the molecule should be dissymmetric. These two are the conditions for a compound is to be optically active. What is chiral, or what kind of molecule is chiral? See, suppose this is a mirror. When you are placing the letter A in front of this mirror, what kind of an image is formed? See this image formed in the mirror. Is this object and mirror image superimposable? Superimposability means if you are keeping the mirror image over to this object, is it exactly suitable or exactly match over to this? Yes. So, now this kind of objects are called achiral. Generally, in chemistry, achiral molecules are optically inactive. See the letter P. What is the mirror image? Image looks like this. Means now this image is non-superimposable over to this object. Now, this kind of molecules are generally called chiral. Generally, chiral molecules are optically active. See, take an example from alkyl halides. Say carbon atom, whose four valencies are satisfied by four different atoms or groups. See, one of the valence is methyl, another ethyl, another hydrogen atom, another by a bromine atom. See the image formed. See, this central carbon is existing as such. Ethyl and methyl, there are no changes. But this bromine is seen on the just inverted direction and hydrogen on the opposite direction. Now you keep this image, mirror image over to this object. Is it superimposable? No. That means anywhere if you are placing the mirror this direction and observe the image formed over here or at this direction or this direction, in any particular direction if you are keeping the mirror, image formed will be non-superimposable with its mirror image. Such kind of molecules are called chiral. So, an object is or molecule is non-superimposable with its mirror image. And now this carbon is called an asymmetric carbon atom, because the four valencies of this carbon are satisfied by four different atoms or group. So, in short, for a molecule is to be optically active in organic chemistry, there must be at least one asymmetric carbon atom, a carbon atom whose four valencies are satisfied by four different atoms or group. The second condition is, I told you, dissymmetry. What is dissymmetry? Dissymmetry means a molecule is said to be dissymmetric when it should not possess a plane of symmetry. The molecule cannot be cut into two equal halves through any particular plane. Such a molecules are called dissymmetric molecules. These two are the conditions for a molecules is to be optically active. So, stereochemistry, there is optical activity, the ability of a substance to rotate the plane of vibration of the plane polarized light either towards right or towards left. If it is towards right, it is dextro, and towards left, it is levo. Optical isomers means, see here, this isomer, suppose this isomer is dextro and this will be levo. So, with the same formula and same structure, with respect to the configuration, there are two isomers, one as dextro, another as levo. So, number of possible examples you can collect from the organic molecules. So, two compounds are having the same molecular formulae, same structure, but their behavior towards the plane polarized light only different. Dextro and levo are called optical isomers. So, condition for a compound is to be optically active. One of the condition is chirality. A molecule is said to be chiral when its mirror image is non-superimposable with its. Dissymmetry means the molecule should not possess a plane of symmetry. Then, enantiomers. These are the points, the important points of stereochemistry, enantiomers. Stereoisomers, same compounds which exist as object and its non-superimposable mirror images are called enantiomers. So, dextrolactic acid and levolactic acid are enantiomers, dextro and levo. Because one of the isomer rotate plane polarized towards right and another rotate towards left. So, they are called enantiomers, dextro and levolactic acid. So, I told you asymmetric carbon atom or stereocenter, a carbon atom whose four valencies are satisfied by four different atoms or groups are known as asymmetric carbon or stereocenter. See, these are the pictures of lactic acid I told you before. Then, what is a racemic mixture? It is an equimolar mixture of dextro and levo isomer is found to be optically inactive. What is the equimolar mixture? Is it 10 ml dextro and 10 ml levo lactic acid? May not be it, because actually the point is molarity, N into V. Here, N is having this similarity. Molarity into volume, total number of particles or molecules, N means 1000 dextro molecules are there, there must be 1000 levo molecules within this, then the mixture is known as racemic mixture, DL plus simultaneously minus. So, such a mixture, an equimolar mixture of dextro and levo isomer is found to be optically inactive because of the external compensation. That means, dextro isomers are rotating the plane polarized light towards right, maybe 10 degree right. The same degree rotation is possible for the levo isomers. So, they get cancelled. That is called external compensation. So, racemic mixture. Then, racemization. The process of conversion of an optically active dextro or levo isomer into the racemic mixture, either dextro tends to DL, because the beaker consists of 100 dextro molecule. After a particular process, 50 molecule converted to LEVO, now it becomes racemic mixture, equimolar mixture of dextro and LEVO, optically inactive. So similarly, LEVO tends to dextro LEVO mixture. This phenomenon, this process known as racemization, the process of conversion of enantiomers into the racemic mixture. Then retention means keeping the configurations as such dextro. After a particular reaction, it is retaining the configurations as such as keeping us dextro and LEVO keeping us LEVO. So retention of configuration is the prevention of the integrity of spatial arrangement of bonds to asymmetric center during a chemical reaction or transformation called retention. Then inversion, it is a process of conversion of dextro isomer. Suppose the beaker consists of 100 dextro molecule. After a particular process, the dextro molecules are turns to LEVO. Dextro becomes LEVO or LEVO becomes dextro. That process known as the inversion in configuration, sometimes regarded as Walden inversion. See, the process of conversion of a dextro isomer or to LEVO and vice versa are known as inversion. Then we are coming back to the chemical properties of alkyl halide, haloalkanes. The reactions of haloalkane, one of the reaction is nucleophilic substitution. You know, substitution means replacing in football or cricket. Substitute means replacing another person by a new one. So here in alkyl halides, Rx, you know, R may be any alkyl group and X is a halogen atom, chlorine, bromine or iodine. So with a nucleophile, suppose the representation of the nucleophile is Nu, the charge of the nucleophile, you know, nucleus loving, it is minus. So Nu minus, any of the nucleophile replacing this halogen atom, now you will get the corresponding compound. Halogen is replaced from there as X minus. So number of nucleophiles are possible. In order to get a particular nucleophile, you should add this, a selective reagent to there. For example, if you are using aqueous alkali, NaOH or KOH, aqueous NaOH or KOH is added, this halogen atom, for example, alkyl iodide or methyl iodide, a particular example, CH3I, the iodine is replaced by the OH group, the result will be an alcohol, an example of nucleophilic substitution. See, here the nucleophile is OH minus. The OH minus can replace the halogen atom and you will get the corresponding alcohol. It's an example of nucleophilic substitution. Substitution by a nucleophile, representation is Nu minus. Number of examples are possible for the nucleophile, as see here, the reagent, suppose the reagent is NaOH or KOH, the nucleophile is OH minus, the resultant product is alcohol, ROH. Similar to that, if RO minus, alkoxide group, for example, CH3ONa is used as the reagent, you will get an ether, corresponding ether is the product. If ammonia is used, ammonia is the nucleophile itself, the result will be a primary amine. See, if potassium cyanide is the reagent, sodium cyanide or potassium cyanide, the nucleophile is CN minus, the result is alkane nitrile, CH3I, and here is NaCN, the result is CH3CN, I minus is replaced. Instead of this ionic compound sodium cyanide, it is ionic, Na plus and CN minus. If you are using another covalent compound AgCN, it is somewhat covalent with respect to sodium cyanide. The result will be an amidan nucleophile, cyanide, and this NC formed from here. CH3NC will be the product because the lone pair of this nitrogen is used for the bonding instead of the carbon minus. And here the result will be an isocyanide. Now cyanide and isocyanide, both are, even though both are nucleophile, they are regarded as ambidan nucleophile. I think you had learned that topic, ambidan ligands, in the coordination chemistry topic so far. See, there is linkage isomerism. Examples are nitro possible with respect to nitrogen atom and oxygen atom, it can bond to a metal ion. Similar to here, here is cyanide and isocyanide. So silver cyanide is a covalent compound, you will get isonitrile. The name of this compound, common name is methyl cyanide, and IUPAC name is ethane nitrile. And here is methyl isocyanide, NC, the group NC is in IUP system called isonitrile or carbylamines. Methyl carbylamine or methyl isonitrile is formed, isocyanate. So similar to that,
There is KNO2 and AgNO2. The nucleophile formed are different, and the product formed in case of KNO2, an ionic compound, it's alkyl nitrite. In case of the example with methyl, if R is methyl CH3, it is methyl nitrite, and if it is AgNO2 is used instead of KNO2, the product obtained will be CH3NO2 nitromethane. See, alkyl nitrite and nitroalkanes. Similar to that, silver salt of carboxylic acid, RCOO- are the nucleophile form, and the final result will be ester. I think that you will discuss later in detail in the third organic chemistry chapter. And lithium aluminum hydride is used, hydrogen is added there, the product will be a hydrocarbon. RH means it is a representation of an alkane. So, and I told you ambient nucleophile possess two nucleophilic centers, cyanides and isocyanates, and cyanide is ionic, so provide CN- ion, and AgCN is mainly covalent. See, in the case of lithium aluminum hydride, actually it is a kind of reduction reaction. Alkyl halides are reduced to a corresponding alkane with lithium aluminum hydride, and also mentioned here in this section of a nucleophilic substitution reaction. See, ambient nucleophile possess two nucleophilic centers, cyanides and isonitrile, and KCN is ionic, provides CN- and AgCN is mainly covalent. Then there are two types of nucleophilic substitution reaction possible in case of alkyl halides. Regarding the kinetic aspects, you know, in chemical kinetics, the rate and order of the reaction that you have learned in chapter 4 or 5. See, alkyl halides Rx react with the nucleophile, the result is the corresponding compound after nucleophilic substitution. There are two types of substitution by nucleophile, SN2 and SN1, SN, substitution by nucleophile 2 and substitution by nucleophile 1. What kind of compound give SN2 mechanism and what kind of compound give SN1? Why it is called SN2 means, with respect to chemical kinetics, the rate of the reaction R is equal to the rate constant R into concentration of the alkyl halide rise to 1 and nucleophile rise to 1. So, now the reaction is regarded as SN2. But in case of SN1 reaction, the rate is R is equal to K into alkyl halide concentration rise to 1 and nucleophile concentration is 0. Why this happened? Because you have learned in the chemical kinetics chapter, in a multi-step reaction, the slowest step is taken as the rate determining step, means in SN1 reaction, the reaction may be taking place in different steps, especially two steps, and in the slowest step, the reactant involved is only the alkyl halide and the nucleophile is involved in the first step. So, it is not the rate determining step. So, alkyl halide is only involved in the rate law. So, we are going to the detailed discussion of bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction, SN2, chemical kinetic aspects. Suppose OH- is the nucleophile, here is the rate law, R is equal to K into Rx into OH-, both powers 1, so order is 2. Methyl chloride most readily undergoes SN2 mechanism. So, what kind of compound undergoes SN2 mechanism and what is the mechanism of the reaction? Especially methyl halide undergoes this reaction. See, CH3Br with OH- forming CH3OH and Br-. The mechanism of this reaction is SN2, SN2 mechanism. Methyl halides and primary alkyl halides mainly give SN2 mechanism, because here there is no chance of formation of a carbocation, because you know the stability of the carbocations. Carbocation means positively charged carbon atom, carbocation or carbonium ion. The order of stability is tertiary greater than secondary than primary than methyl carbocation. So, Br- leaving and methyl cation formation is least stable, there is no chance of formation of such a methyl carbocation, then the only possibility is in the slowest step, a backside attack. See, suppose here is the alkyl halide molecule, here is the alkyl halide molecule. See this, alkyl halide molecule, this is the leaving bromine atom, the central carbon atom here, and here are the three valencies satisfied by, here example, hydrogen atom.
hydrogen, 3 hydrogen atom, and here is the halogen atom. In the slowest step itself, the nucleophile attacks from the backside. This is the way of formation of the transition state. See here, bromine, 3 hydrogen atom. The bromine, the leaving part is bromine, but the OH minus attacks from the backside. From here, the OH minus attacks. And now, the intermediate formation is the carbon bromine bond is not fully broken, and the carbon OH bond is not fully formed. This is the slowest step. So, in the slow step itself, both alkyl halide and the nucleophile are involved. That is why I told you before, it is an SN2 mechanism. And in the first step only, bromine is leaving. The next step, this bromine is leaving and OH minus is fixed over there. So, suppose, actually this example of methyl bromide is not an optically active molecule, you know, because this is not an asymmetric carbon atom. These valencies are similar. If suppose the molecule is, all the valencies are different. Here hydrogen, here two positions, some other group, and here a bromine atom. It is an optically active molecule. Suppose this molecule is dextro, here the valencies may be different, A, B and C. It's an now it is an optically active alkyl halide, and OH minus is placed over here. Then finally bromine is leaving from there. Suppose the starting molecule is dextro, the final result obtained will be levo. The valencies are inversed, A, B and C opposite, and OH minus fixed over here. See, the leaving group, this is the leaving group, bromine, and here is a OH group. Now, suppose initially the molecule is dextro and finally the molecule becomes levo. That is what is, here is what kind of process taking place based on the stereochemical aspects. Here is inversion in configuration, means dextro tends to levo or levo tends to dextro. So, simply in SN2 mechanism, there is inversion in the configuration. See, the order of reactivity is based on the SN2 mechanism. This is the order of reactivity, methyl chloride the top, methyl halide, not chloride, methyl halide is the top, then primary, then secondary, tertiary. This is the order of reactivity for SN2 mechanism. SN2, methyl halide most readily undergoes SN2 mechanism followed by primary, the least tertiary. See, in SN2 mechanism, I told you, if the molecule is optically active or inactive, generally the term used is, in the case of an SN2 mechanism, there is a process of inversion. Whatever be the nature of the compound, it is optically active or inactive. The leaving group is bromine, kept over here. And OH is attacked from the backside. So, bromine is left from here and OH is placed here. Suppose this example is not an optically active molecule, even then, generally it is regarded. There is a kind of inversion, whether it is optically active or inactive, there is a process of inversion takes place. And the configuration is just inverse, that is what is called inversion configuration. Yes, now we are moving to the SN1 mechanism. See, the order of reactivity of SN1 mechanism is this one. Just reverse of the previous SN2 case. In the case of SN2, this is the top reactive and is the minimum. And here the tertiary is maximum reactive regarding SN1. And the least reactive is methyl halide. Because the mechanism is just different from SN2. Here, in case of tertiary carbocation, the stability is maximum. That is why here a carbon atom with different alkyl group, carbon atom, maybe methyl, here ethyl, here propyl or any other group, and this is halogen atom, it is a tertiary carbon atom. A carbon connected to 3 other carbon atom, tertiary carbocation is formed from here. Bromine is leaving and a flat molecule, see please, suppose initially the molecule is like this. Here is a carbon atom, central carbon, asymmetric center, and here different alkyl group, maybe same or different, methyl, ethyl, propyl, etc. And here the halogen atom, bromine. So, first of all, this bromine is leaving from that position. Bromine is leaving, and here this kind of a flat molecule is formed because the hybridization get changed from sp3 to sp2. This kind of a carbocation is formed, a positive charge carbon atom, because it is stable, and this is a slow step, a carbocation is formed. And now in the fast step, only OH minus, the nucleophile, attacks on the carbocation. In the second step, the hybridization of this carbon is sp3 changes to sp2, and now in the second step, the first step, nucleophile attack. Now two possibilities are there. Initially I told you this is the way of representing. The bromine is leaving from here, a flat carbocation is formed this way. Now the incoming OH minus can approach us from this side. Now just opposite, the initial molecule is dextro, the resultant alcohol will be levo. Here is the way of bromine leaving, and if OH minus is coming from this side, it is inversion. And if it is from the same side, OH minus approach from the same side, it is same as that of the original dextro. So two chances are there for dextro and levo. So one of the possibilities, there may be a possibility of racemic mixture, because equimolar chances are there. Now if equal proportions of dextro and levo are formed, now the mixture will be a racemic mixture, even though the starting compound is either dextro or levo. The starting compound may be dextro or levo, the final mixture there, it may be a racemic mixture. That is a process of racemization takes place, that you have learned just before. Racemization takes place here. See, dextro or levo tends to racemic mixture. So methyl chloride most readily undergoes SN2. The order of reactivity of SN2, I told you, nucleophile attack the alkyl halide through the backside, inversion configuration takes place. And in SN1 mechanism, these reactions are generally carried out in polar protic solvents like water, alcohol, acetic acid, etc. SN1 mechanism. Tertiary butyl halide undergoes nucleophilic substitution by SN1 mechanism. So this is the regla. Here is a way of mechanism. Bromine is leaving, carbocation is formed, the slow step. The carbocation attacks the nucleophile, fast step. So greater the stability of the carbocation, greater will be its ease of formation from alkyl halide, and faster will be the rate of the SN1 reaction. The order of reactivity of SN1 is just opposite of that of SN2. Then allyl halide undergoes nucleophilic substitution reaction by SN1 mechanism. So here two compounds are mentioned in contradictory to the expected. One of the compound is allyl, CH2 double bond CH, CH3 is propene, one of the hydrogen is replaced, it is allyl. Now it is allyl chloride, OH minus is replacing the halogen atom chlorine. Now the result is allyl alcohol. What kind of mechanism it follows? The expected mechanism is SN2, but really it is SN1. Why? Because here if chlorine is leaving and carbocation is formed, this chlorine is leaving Cl minus, and here the carbocation is formed. That carbocation undergoes a stabilization through resonance because of the possibility of this pi bond. Pi bond shifted to this position, this electron will shifting of this pair of electrons to this position, and this carbon will get positive charge. So it is allyl halide, because of the formation of the chance of formation of a possible allyl carbocation, the molecule undergoes SN1 reaction instead of SN2. Similarly, benzyl halides, this is a compound called benzyl. In benzene ring, if CH3 is there, methyl, on the hydrogen of that alkyl part is replaced. Now it is benzyl chloride. This chlorine is replaced by OH-. The expected mechanism, because it's an sp3 hybridized carbon atom, so the expected mechanism is SN2, but really it is SN1. Here also there is a possibility of a stable carbocation of benzyl. Benzyl carbocation is formed, it undergoes stabilization because of the presence of these pi bonds in the ring. So shifting of electron towards here. Now here the pi bonds are same, and this carbon become carbocation, and here arises the double bond, it gets stabilized. Similarly, these positive charges can spread over this para and another ortho position. So that's a way of stabilization of the benzyl carbocation, that's why it undergoes SN1 mechanism instead of SN2. So benzyl and allyl compounds are undergoing SN1 reactions. Then in short, SN2 mechanism, there is inversion, and in SN1 reaction there is racemization. Now we are moving to certain elimination reactions. Alkyl halides on treating with alcoholic potash, a hydrogen halide is eliminated, it is another reaction with alcoholic potash. This halogen atom from the alpha carbon and the hydrogen atom from the beta carbon is eliminated, and here is a double bond, the result is an alkene, it is an elimination reaction, HCl is leaving. See, it is a beta elimination, dehydrohalogenation or beta elimination. So there is a rule called Seitzhoff's rule. If there is two chances of possibility of alkyl halides with alcoholic AOH, suppose this compound is an alkyl halide, secondary butyl bromide or 2-bromobutane, bromine can leave along with this hydrogen atom, and here arises a double bond. Another possibility is from this hydrogen atom, here arises double bond. So the major product obtained is this 2-butene. This is on the basis of a rule called Seitzhoff's rule. It is a major product obtained, and the minor product is but-1-ene, but-2-ene is the major products. Then see this reaction with metals that you know, you have learned last year as formation of Grignard's reagent and Wood's reaction. Alkyl halides on treating with sodium metal in dry ether medium, for example, methyl iodides with sodium metal in dry ether medium. So, two molecules of methyl iodide react with two atoms of sodium and forming ethane, CH3, 2-NaI is leaving. This kind of reaction is known as Wood's reaction. Alkyl halides on treating with sodium metal in dry ether medium, higher alkanes are formed. Such reactions are known as Wood's reaction. And alkyl halides on treating with magnesium metal in dry ether medium, you will get alkyl magnesium halide, general formula RMGX, called Grignard's reagent. See, these are the important reactions of alkyl halide. Now it's the time for discussing some questions based on this. See, the first question, the carbon atom holding bromine atom in allyl bromide is, options are sp3 hybridized, sp hybridized, sp2, sp3d and sp3d2, you know, allyl halides, the halogen connected carbon. The correct answer is answer A, because allyl halide is this compound, and this carbon is not, these two are sp2 and this is sp3. Second question, the compound which undergoes SN1 reaction with a faster rate is, options are methyl chloride, ethyl iodide, propyl bromide, tertiary butyl bromide and 2-bromopropane. See, the correct answer is answer D, because tertiary butyl bromide, I told you before, tertiary alkyl halide undergoes SN1 reaction with a faster rate. Question number 3. A molecule is said to be chiral when, options are: it is superimposable with its mirror image, not superimposable with its mirror image, it cannot rotate the plane of vibration of the plane polarized light, it contain minimum 2 asymmetric carbon atom, it contain no asymmetric carbon atom. It's a simple question, you know. The answer is B. A molecule is said to be chiral when it is non-superimposable with its mirror image. Question number 4. The number of asymmetric carbon atom present in glucose is, here actually in a normal entrance question the structure of glucose is not given, but here it is given because you will discuss the structure of glucose in the last chapter only, biomolecules. So how many asymmetric carbon atoms are there in the glucose? Options are 3, 4, 5, 0 and 2. The correct answer is C. So 4 asymmetric carbon atoms are there in the glucose. This is the structure of glucose. Listen, see, total 6 carbon atoms are there in glucose. Formula is C6H12O6. The top carbon is CHO carbon. The remaining valencies are like this. The configurations, except in the third carbon atom, in all other positions, OH on right side and H on left side. This is a carbon. And this carbon is not an asymmetric carbon because two valencies are satisfied by the same oxygen atom. Here also, this is not an asymmetric carbon, two valency by hydrogen atom. But the remaining carbon atoms are chiral centers, asymmetric, because all the four valencies are different. See, what's the four valencies? Hydrogen, OH, and here not carbon as a whole. And here also as a whole is the valency. So these four carbon atoms are chiral centers, asymmetric carbon. Question number 5. The stereoisomers related to each other as non-superimposable mirror images are called. Options: racemic mixture, enantiomers, diastereomers, achiral molecule, Walden inversion isomers. So what's the correct answer of question number 5? Answer is B. Enantiomers. You know, it's a simple question. Stereoisomers related to each other as non-superimposable mirror images are called enantiomers. Question number 6. The major product obtained when 2-bromopentane is treated with alcoholic KOH is pentatoin. It can be explained on the basis of which rule? So, the major product, based on the major product, there's a question. Options are Marconi-Coase rule, Karasch effect, anti-Marconi-Coase rule, Zaitsev's rule or peroxide effects. See the correct answer? It is option D, Zaitsev's rule. So the answer is given over there. 2-bromopentane is given. So on the basis of Zaitsev's rule, the major product is pentatoin. Question number 7. The product obtained when 2-chloropropane is subjected to Wood's reaction. Options are option A, normal hexane, B, 2,3-dimethylbutane. C, 2,3-dimethylpentane, D, 2,2-dimethylbutane, option E, 2,3-dimethylhexane. What's the correct answer? The answer is B, that is 2,3-dimethylbutane. The question is, the product obtained when 2-chloropropane is subjected to, what's 2-chloropropane? This is 2-chloropropane. Subjected to Wood's reaction, treating with the sodium metal in dry ether medium. This is the way of formation of the bonds. See this? 2-NaCl is eliminated and here will be the bond formed between 2-CH groups. So the product obtained is 2,3-dimethylbutane. So the correct answer is 2,3-dimethylbutane. Question number 8. The alkane which is not obtained by treating methyl iodides, ethyl iodides and sodium metal in dry ether medium. So based on the Wood's reaction, options are methane, propane, butane, pentane, both A and D. That is option E. The alkane which is not obtained by treating methyl iodide, ethyl iodide and sodium. The correct answer is E. So methyl ethyl. Which are alkanes are not obtained? So this is the methyl iodide. This is the ethyl iodide. These two on treating with sodium metal in dry ether medium. Which alkanes are not formed? Methane is not formed. Never methane is formed by Wood's reaction. And another possibility is option D, pentane. Other two possibilities are formed because two molecules of ethyl iodide with the sodium give ethane. Two molecules of ethyl iodide with the sodium give butane. That is Wood's reaction. The carbon atoms get doubled. That is why the correct answer is option E. Question number 9. The process of conversion of enantiomer into racemic mixture is known as inversion, retention, racemization, resolution, asymmetric carbon atom. What is the correct answer? The answer is C. Racemization, process of conversion of enantiomer into the racemic mixture. Question number 10. The alkyl halide which undergoes SN reaction with an inversion, the configuration is which compound among these undergoes nucleophilic substitution by inversion configuration? Options are allyl chloride, benzyl chloride, tertiary butyl chloride, normal propyl chloride, and tertiary pentyl chloride. The correct answer is D. Which is D? It's normal propyl chloride. That is the one and only primary alkyl halide among these. But here option A is allyl, but you know, even though it's primary carbon, but due to the resonance stabilization undergoes SN1 mechanism, benzyl chloride also undergoes SN1 mechanism, tertiary, option C, tertiary butyl, so tertiary carbon, and option E, tertiary pentyl, that's also tertiary. Then the only chance for SN2 mechanism is the option D. That's why it undergoes SN reaction with SN2 and the inversion configuration. The remaining portions, the chemical reactivity of aryl halides and polyhalogen compound will be discussed in the next episode, and have a nice day. Thank you.